I'll only agree with you because he isn't here. I hate to say good things about him when he's here, but I miss him.
You've never been afraid of telling the truth either.
No,
he's a great competitor.
No, I'm not afraid of telling the truth. He is, and I'm not afraid of saying here is one dangerous man walking down the aisle. No, not Lumpy, the second guy.
Very dangerous. And you know, Hot Rod, it seems to me as though there's somewhat of an unholy alliance that has formed these days between Jake the Snake Roberts and The Undertaker.
How low can you go? I didn't know you can hide under the belly of a snake. It is one thing, you know, to do something just on the spur of the moment. It's another thing to be premeditated enough with The Undertaker and Paul Bearer and Jake the Snake to sit back and think, how can I ruin a reception? How can I scare a poor little girl with a snake? How can I hit a man over the head with an urn? How can I just destroy a life, destroy a marriage? You're a pig! Did I make myself clear?
I think you made yourself very, very clear. And one day, I think it's pretty safe to say that Jake Roberts and The Undertaker will return from the depths that they know best. One day that's going to happen. If anybody can help that happen, it's going to be a man by the name of Sid Justice, or it's going to be a man, if in fact he's reinstated, folks, it's going to be a man by the name of the Macho Man.
A savage. That's a Sid and a savage. Kind of Jake getting the hint.
Yeah. Kind of hissing sound.
Kind of hissing.
And they're all gunning. And perhaps for that man there, definitely for Jake the Snake Roberts as well as The Undertaker.
But can you imagine if a guy like Sid Justice decides to play by their rules? What are you going to do with a 6'7", 280-pound snake, folks?
I don't know. Perhaps.
They don't either, I don't think.
Could it be that justice would prevail? Look at that. Look at that.
Strong. Ugly.
Morbid.
Suppose he could have been Opie.
He could be anything he wants to be. There are going to be few people that argue with this man.
And you know, in watching him, I think an approach to fighting this man here would be to change his pace. You notice how he always controls the pace. He controls the race all the time, making you go at his speed. That way, he never gets tired. The idea is either pick it up a half a step or drop it half a step, and you'll start to confuse him. Paul Bearer,
To me, the guy Hot Rod is only half human. I'm not sure what the other half is, but I think he's only half human. I don't know that this man can feel pain. I don't know that he can get tired. I don't know anything at all about this Undertaker other than he is most strange.
Yeah, just check his head out.
And
man,
you know, I mean, for a guy like this, and a guy like Jake the Snake Roberts, to derive pleasure out of sending Elizabeth,
I don't get it,
on her wedding night for shock.
I don't get it. And you guys, if you think that Justice and Macho are just...
Speaking of shock.
Look at that.
Bill Roark, opponent of The Undertaker, just went into shock, all right, after that, as anyone would.
Man.
The morbid tones of The Undertaker.
Hey, Lumpy.
And the unholy alliance continues to bond between Jake the Snake Roberts, Paul Bearer, and The Undertaker.
So now what's the deal? You want
the
match?
Urn shaking?
Yeah, that's Lumpy coming up the stairs there.
I'm not so sure about that.
You think there's something in there?
I don't know. Let's go back and take a look at the replay.
Well, you want to see it. Look at the height and agility. This is a 6'5" man in there. The tombstone. No getting up once you're buried.
I don't know. Could that be Sid Justice that they would place in the body bag? Could it be the Macho Man himself?
Do they make body bags that big?
A look of awe on the face of those in attendance. Oh, man!
Your time will come.
Yeah, that's his line. Let's take you now to the event center.